Illinois Stories is brought to you by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by the support of viewers like you. Thank you.
Hello, welcome to Illinois Stories. I'm Mark McDonald in Champaign County near Homer, being introduced today to a profession that I didn't know anything about. The profession is that of the farrier, the horseshoer. It hasn't changed much in hundreds of years. As you can see, he needs everything on site. He's got his hoof stand, a variety of tools with nippers and rasps and saws and blades, an anvil, a forge. Half shoes will travel in Champaign County. Well, Darla Finley, before we get into horseshoeing, we got to meet the patient.
Okay, perfect.
You know, and I guess the patient is your horse.
Yes,
uh-huh. Rain.
Yes, Rain Cloud.
Is that right?
Rain Cloud.
Rain
uh-huh.
Cloud.
Yep.
He's very cooperative, isn't he?
Yes, he is most of the time.
What kind of horse is he?
He's a Percheron Appaloosa Cross.
So the Percheron, that's a draft
horse.
That is
a draft
species,
breed.
Right?
Uh-huh.
A
yes.
Breed. Yeah. Yeah. And that means large, powerful.
Yes.
In many cases, very big hooves.
Yes.
And that's why we're here today, to take a look at the hooves,
right.
Et cetera. So, but he's also very cooperative,
oh,
right?
Oh, most everything I've ever done with him, he's like, what's next?
Uh-huh, okay,
yeah.
So he's pretty much good.
Oh,
he's
yes.
A very cooperative horse. And you've had him for how long?
Good question. About 6 years.
Mm-hmm. And he's how old?
13.
13. So Percheron would live normally under normal circumstances. How old would he
well,
live?
Well, horses in general, I would say 25 is a rough estimate. I do know of one draft horse that's over 30 years old.
Mm-hmm.
So the nutrition has changed so much for these animals. Even the dental care to the foot care, which we'll see today,
yeah, yeah.
Just the nutrition needs that they have. They're living a lot longer.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not worked like they were back in the day.
Yeah. Yeah, which is good and bad.
Yes,
they probably, you have to keep them in condition, so
right.
You do have to move them and work
definitely.
Them a little bit, but they don't work themselves to death,
right.
I guess, like they used
right.
to. And with this guy, what would he, if he were a workhorse,
mm-hmm.
what would he be doing?
Possibly pulling farm equipment. I do know he came from a ranch in South Dakota,
mm-hmm.
And I was told that they checked fence lines with him. And I suspicion maybe they put him in harness to feed cattle in the winter, possibly.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And you're going to use him, aren't you?
I'm planning to, yes.
Yeah.
I'm in the beginnings of teaching him to drive.
To drive what?
I've got an antique doctor's buggy.
Yeah.
I'll probably start with a two-wheel cart that some friends have loaned me.
Uh-huh.
It's a better way to do it. But I do have him, I do have a harness for him that I've been working with
uh-huh.
that he's taken right to.
Really?
Yes.
So he'll be pulling you around in your doctor's buggy.
Yes.
Well, how
uh-huh.
neat is
yeah,
that?
Yeah.
Maybe later in the program we can see that buggy.
Oh,
huh?
certainly.
Because you've restored it, right?
Well,
it's an old.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
Uh-huh, yes.
Oh, neat.
Yeah.
Neat.
Yeah.
Okay, now, this horse has, I understand it, he regularly gets his hooves
trimmed. Yes.
But he's never been shod.
No.
Right,
right. Not to my knowledge.
So we're gonna, that's gonna be an experience.
Yeah.
Our friend Steve Rice is gonna
definitely.
Take this on for the first time when he shows us how he shoes horses.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be interesting to see how Rain handles it.
Right.
Yeah. But he's such a good-natured horse, you feel pretty confident that
I really don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know.
Driving a nail into his foot for the first time?
Right.
Who knows, right?
Right?
Okay, so we got a little suspense. Okay, well, listen, thank you. We'll talk
certainly.
To you later in the program.
All right.
But I think Steve's getting ready to go ahead and trim him up, and we're going to also, would he mind if I touched
no,
his
not
head
at all.
Here? He's
not
pretty,
at all.
Oh, you are a good man. You're a good man. You are a good man. Okay, now we're going to get ready to do a little work, huh? Okay. Well, Steve Rice, you've been shoeing horses in this area for almost 30 years now.
Yes.
One of the first things you do is not is this going to be to trim the hooves?
Yes, it is.
Okay, so you start out with a sharp knife.
A sharp knife, you got to have a sharp knife.
Yeah.
And it took me a while to learn how to sharpen it, but
is that right?
It takes a while.
It's pretty automatic for you right now,
I'll
isn't
tell you,
it?
Most of the what I do, it takes a while to learn.
Uh-huh.
It just you just don't do it overnight.
Yeah, but then once you learn it, it's kind of automatic for you.
Yeah,
I guess,
it is.
Huh?
But there's something different every day.
Uh-huh.
And but that's why I like the thing, and that's why I do it.
Yeah. You and other farriers have to be prepared for what you're going to see in the field.
Exactly.
You've got this kind of cool pickup truck that's been modified for you. It's got, it's, you know, enclosed.
Right.
You got shelves and everything.
Right.
You got everything in here you would encounter on a stop for to shoe a horse.
99% of the time.
If you're on top of your game, you got everything you need.
If there's things I need, I got some people I can call that are really good people, mm-hmm. that help me out on questions. There's a Dr. Monfort over at Farmer City, mm-hmm. and there's a real good shoer around named Steve Simmersheim. Mm-hmm. I've always asked him questions. Mm-hmm. And then I got a couple people, my cousin and another man down in Danville. They know horses, and I talked to them about a John Drews and a Marianne Reveal. And mm-hmm. Those are pretty much the people I talk to that really think know their stuff.
Yeah.
And I guess I can't think of anything else on that, but just I really enjoy it.
Yeah. And well, it's something different every day. But I'll tell you what, I would have, the horses are so big and powerful, and when you start messing around with their legs and their feet, it's a little intimidating sometimes, I would think.
It is. It can be. I always keep a little bit of fear in the back of my head.
Yeah.
Because I tell people, I don't care how gentle the horse is, every one of them kicks and every one of them bites.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
and every one of them's bigger than you.
Right. And they're light, and they're a service animal.
Yeah.
They're supposed to perform and work for us, but they can be powerful when they want to be.
Yeah, yeah.
And you really have to understand that. Yeah. You got to understand the horse.
You got some stuff set out here for us. And as you get ready, go ahead and explain to us what you're going to do here.
Well, this is my apron. It's been around a little bit, but this really protects your legs and mm-hmm. from nails especially.
Boy, that has been around.
Yeah,
Did you buy that used, or is that just 30 years of use?
No. This is about my fourth apron.
Is that right? You wear them out, huh?
In fact, it's getting close to being retired.
Wow.
But it's like something else. You get used to it, like an old mm-hmm. shoe, and it feels
comfortable. It just feels right. Yep. Okay.
Right.
What do you have in here ready to go?
Okay, I got my knives.
Mm-hmm.
I like two because I can on either side of the horse, I'm ready to go with mm-hmm. it. And then.
And even though this has Velcro, huh? What'd they do before Velcro?
Well, sometimes a lot of guys, they don't even like to have them tied together. They mm-hmm. like them loose.
Yeah.
They've had kind of hooks before, but the Velcro I like.
Oh, I don't blame you.
I like these because they keep my pants cleaner.
So. And I like this because your hat has a built-in visor.
Yeah, yeah.
That's nifty.
It's just a farmer's hat, but in the sun, I got to wear it.
Yeah.
So,
okay. And this is all set out
this
now.
This is my farrier's box.
Okay.
And that's... this is a hoof gauge to measure the angle of the horse's hoof to the mm-hmm. ground.
Okay.
And to the bones that go up the foot, like the pastern.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, my hammer and right here is the nippers.
Mm-hmm.
That's a real important tool.
Mm-hmm.
That nips the hoof off.
Mm-hmm.
And then the rasp to shape it mm-hmm. and get it level. So that's pretty much a hoof pick to clean the horse out.
Mm-hmm.
But that's pretty much it.
Okay. So what we're going to be doing today, now normally the horse we're with today, Rain, is a horse that you trim the hooves.
Right.
And I think we already explained that he's never been shot before.
Right.
So you're going to actually go ahead and put shoes on him, which is going to be an experience for you and for us.
Yeah, sometimes it can be exciting.
Yeah. Okay. Terrific.
I'll tell you.
Now before you do that, you got to choose a shoe that you think might fit. And you got a whole array of shoes in here, all kinds of sizes of shoes. So you choose a big one because he's a big horse.
He's a big horse. Hopefully I'm going to go with that.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll get it heated up and shape it to his hoof.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a pretty good size shoe. And I think it's going to work.
You trust it'll be big enough, huh?
Right.
But you heat it up first anyway because you know that you're going to have to bend it somewhere.
Right.
It's not going to be a perfect fit,
right.
Huh?
I think once in a blue moon I'll bring a shoe and it's for that horse.
Mm-hmm.
It was made for that horse without doing anything, but that's...
Oh, you love that, though, don't you?
Oh, yeah. That doesn't happen very often, though. You know, maybe three or four times in my life.
So,
you know?
While you're trimming, that'll be heating up, and then you'll come over to this anvil, and you'll do a little bend it.
Exactly.
Huh? Bang
it
around a little
bit. Shape it to the horse's hoof.
Okay.
You always shape the shoe to the hoof and not the hoof to the shoe.
Okay. Well, perfect. Well, let's go ahead and get that started heating up, and then we'll do a little trimming, huh?
Okay. That sounds good.
Well, Steve, the Farrier trade, it hadn't changed much in hundreds of years, has it?
I don't think it has. Yeah. Propane forges.
Yeah, right.
Rather than coal.
Which you got one going right now.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I can't see anything. Mm-hmm. I've seen pictures. In fact, these are pull-offs. And I got a picture of him. John Hoff. He was the last horseshoer before me in Potomac.
Yeah.
And he started in 1889.
Yeah.
And his last horse was my dad's horse in 1961. And he
died. Had the same tool, huh?
And his son gave me these.
Is that right?
And I know these are 120
and
years old.
And they work just as good as
right.
they should, don't they?
In fact, they work better.
Yeah, yeah.
And his dad, this John Hoff's dad, was a farrier too.
The first thing you need to do before you even think about putting a shoe on is you got to trim that. And even some horses don't wear shoes, you still got to trim their hooves,
yes,
don't you?
That's
a constant care kind of thing.
The hoof grows about a quarter to half an inch every 4 weeks, every
mm-hmm.
month,
mm-hmm.
just like our fingernail.
Yeah, so how often do you trim a horse?
Working really, a working horse, they should be done probably every 4 weeks, but my customers average 6 to 8 weeks.
Uh-huh. Well, let's start the process for us.
Okay.
Show us what you're looking for.
Okay.
Okay, first you calm him down a little
right.
bit.
Right.
Huh? Okay.
He's a good horse.
He's
Make
a big sure horse.
I let him know that I'm here, and he picks his hoof up. Real
uh-huh.
good horse. When they pick their hooves up like that, you know you got a good horse.
That's a good horse, huh?
So you just get all this crap out and dirt.
And that doesn't bother him either,
no,
huh?
No,
no. Just rub away, huh?
No, this is all insensitive hoof
mm-hmm.
on the top here. And you mm-hmm. get down to the sole. Man, he's really grown nice, Darla. Really even.
Yeah, and Darla's holding him for you. In many cases, you wouldn't have anybody holding the horse for you.
I've done it. You can cross tie it where you have the head with ropes coming out
mm-hmm.
on each side of the post, or tie them up. I've done them a lot of different ways.
Mm-hmm.
Some horses that don't tie, I've done them with a lead rope in my back pocket,
mm-hmm.
and they think they're tied, and I can get the rope if something happens.
Yeah, you hope they don't take off on you then.
Right.
That's
for
sure, don't you?
And then
what's that tool?
This is a hoof knife.
A hoof knife, okay. Is that what you were sharpening before?
Yes, it was.
Okay.
And what you do, you get down to new growth.
And you know it's new because it's white?
Right.
Okay.
And this here is what I'm going to be trimming off.
The outside?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Is that where the like you said, the fingernail, that's where the growth is, mostly
right,
on the outside?
Exactly.
Okay.
And you get down. There we go.
And you don't worry about the inside, the middle part, very much, huh?
No, I just want to make sure that the sole is not going to be too thin to
uh-huh.
where he gets sore.
Uh-huh.
Then this here's the frog. This is the blood pump of the hoof. And you basically just clean it up a little bit.
You don't whittle away at that, though. You just get the crud off it, huh?
Right.
Okay.
And the frog, ideally, you don't want the frog any higher than the edge of the hoof.
Uh-huh.
Because this hits the ground, pushes blood into the hoof, and uh-huh. when the hoof's off the ground, the frog holds the hoof together.
Okay, all right. So that frog has to be healthy. You
gotta
keep that
in
good health.
And this is a good, healthy frog.
And they don't grow, they just...
They grow.
Oh, they do?
They do. And they shed once or twice a year. The whole frog just comes off and there's a new one underneath.
Oh, okay. Well, that's godsend, isn't it?
Okay. Yeah.
And then how do you know when you've got it just to the right level?
Well, there's a point here. Here's the point of the frog.
Mm-hmm.
Back here a little bit. Just like, what is it, Leonardo da Vinci when he did the man?
Yeah, yeah.
Standing
right.
out in the circles, the mm-hmm. same thing with the hoof. Every hair all the way around should be equidistant
uh-huh.
with that.
Okay.
Because it's a circle, basically.
It's a circle, okay.
And I'm looking at it now to see if he's high or low. He's a little high on his heel, and he's just a little bit here. But I won't take too much off, and he'll be...
And then you'll have it perfect.
Right, well... Yeah, that's the idea.
Okay, and what's that tool called?
The nippers.
Nippers, okay.
It's just basically a big fingernail.
Mm-hmm. And that doesn't hurt him? He doesn't feel a thing?
No,
it's incredible.
No.
Because that's a pretty crude tool when you think about what you're doing.
Yeah.
Wow. But that works just like it did in the 1880s.
Yeah, so. same deal. And then this is the rasp. Mm-hmm. This is where you get everything nice and level.
Yeah.
And the idea, like where my knees are, mm-hmm. that's the way I want the rasp to go. Mm-hmm. In fact, kind of learned that from the Drewses, John Dave Drews down in Danville. John's dad was a real good horseshoer.
Uh-huh.
Passed away here a year ago, but you could really talk to him and learn things.
Yeah. Is the rasp then, is that the last step?
Pretty much.
Mm-hmm. Now you're just cleaning it up, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it's very important, drop my knife, that we see the heels here.
Mm-hmm.
You want these heels to be spread at all times as much as you can, because they can contract in,
mm-hmm.
and there's bones inside the hoof,
mm-hmm.
and that can put pressure on them and really squeeze them,
okay.
and it's not good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And he's good, huh?
Now that's pretty flat and level. Okay. Now, this is a hoof stand, and you've more or less finish the hoof on top. I'm going to come around this way. Okay. These hoof stands are great. Okay. Oh boy.
Well, that's a big hoof. That is a big hoof.
Yeah. And what you want to do, where the hairline comes down, you want everything just to just mm-hmm. straight down with no. You see, I got a little opening there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to try to get that off
mm-hmm.
a little bit. I'm going to get the dirt off and stuff.
That horse is looking right over your shoulder to make sure you're doing a good job.
I know, and I'm always conscious of horses. Maybe I don't want a hard kiss from them.
No, you don't. But he's keeping an eye on you to make sure you're doing the right thing.
Sometimes they'll grab my hat. younger horses do that more.
Mm-hmm. They just want to play around a little bit, huh?
Yeah, exactly. But Darla went to where she goes to her riding club.
Mm-hmm.
They gave me a few tips on trimming him. And like I said, you learn something every day.
Mm-hmm.
The whole idea is to try to keep the hoof together and not be spread out.
I got you.
Away. Yeah, that's pretty good there.
Okay, so that's been in the forage for quite a few minutes.
Yes,
hasn't
it has.
It? And you've got a mental picture in your mind about what shape it has to be.
I do. I got to open these nail holes.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Because when you beat on it, hammer, they'll close up. And I want to make sure the nails go in there good.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And that's one's personalized for rain.
Yes, yes it is.
Just the right size and shape. Okay, now you got it the size shape and you got the nail holes
right.
Open.
Now I'm gonna get it, make sure I get it leveled up here. Okay.
Just right, huh?
Looks pretty good.
Okay.
Now I'm gonna do what they call a hot check on this horse. He's never had one, so okay. We're gonna give it a shot.
Is he gonna feel the heat?
Well, he shouldn't. I mean, he will, but it shouldn't. It might just surprise him, but we'll see. I'll do it. Come on, boy.
Give. Pick it up, Rain. There you go,
okay.
Buddy. There you go.
Okay. Okay, you see those? That's a real good trim. I think it's a good
trim.
Do that
a good for again for us, will you, Steve? So
okay.
We see that.
You put it.
Yeah, I see. I see how that happens. Okay.
And then
whoa.
You see these here?
Yes.
These marks? That's where the hoof was high.
Mm-hmm.
So everything is right down level. When it goes on, it'll be flat right mm-hmm. on the shoe will be flat right on the hoof.
Good now, gauge, huh? You gauged right.
It's pretty close.
Yeah.
It's pretty close. I got to do a little bit here. Okay. Yeah, that's going to look pretty good.
Okay, Steve, it's cooled a little bit, but not all the way,
not
right?
Not all the way.
Wow. That still got a lot of heat in it.
Yes, it does. That forge heats up to about 1,200 pounds.
And why are you dipping it and taking it out?
Because I want it to really keep cooling gradually because
gradually.
The molecules in the steel, if it's just laid in there and left, mm-hmm. they just get real hard and it's hard to move mm-hmm. the shoe around, the steel around, the shape.
Okay. Now you're going to do one last check. You're going to take,
right.
You've done the heat check. Now you're going to take it over there and do one last check before
That's
you
right.
nail it on?
That's right.
Okay. Okay, Steve, you had to eyeball this again and again and again and shape it just perfect. And you're very content now that you got the right shape and
yes.
everything with it.
Yes, yes.
And what
indeed.
You're going to do is you got eight. These are pretty interesting, these nails.
Right.
This is, look how long that is. And you're going to
yeah.
shove that right into his hoof.
Yes. Okay, it's interesting. Remember we talked about the frog there?
Yeah, the middle. Yeah.
Okay, on every horseshoe, there's a smooth side and then there's always some sort of design.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's the frog. This is called the eye.
Okay.
And the eye always looks at the frog.
Okay.
Because if you don't, the nail is tipped up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So when you drive it, it comes out the side of the hook,
mm-hmm.
like
mm-hmm.
the bow of a boat.
Mm-hmm.
The faster you drive it, the quicker it comes out, and
mm-hmm.
the slower, the higher it comes
okay.
out.
Okay. All right. So you always want the rough side facing the frog,
right.
facing the
yeah,
inside.
That's the eye. The mm-hmm. eye, the... The eye of the nail faces the frog,
okay.
looks at the frog.
All
the
right.
eye of the nail looks at the frog.
Okay. Well, let's see how we nail that
okay.
on there, because I don't think I'm going to be able to believe that a horse can take that kind of that kind of treatment. But when you say their hooves, they feel nothing.
Well.
You hope.
Yeah.
You hope.
Because here, this is called the white line.
Mm-hmm.
And this is here is what you have to nail. You go into here,
uh-oh.
You get into the quick.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
and that's blood.
Yeah.
And he'll jump real high.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, Rain. Big guy. Good boy. You feel good, Rain? Easy, big guy. This is called setting the shoe.
Mm-hmm. Do opposite sides so you make sure that you
yeah.
get it balanced, huh? Oh, I see. And then you just pound the end of that nail back up
yeah.
against itself.
Oh, Rain, you're just such a good horse.
He is a good horse.
We want me.
And we don't know that this horse has ever had shoes on. He's even better than we thought.
Huh? Yeah. Oh, it was Darla. He's a keeper.
Look at that nail come out the bottom. Yep, that's what you wanted, huh?
Right. Good boy. Easy.
You ever been kicked, Steve?
Yes, I have.
I'll bet you have.
But not very often. And the, almost all, every time that I have been hurt, it was my own fault.
Mm-hmm.
Not thinking. Good boy, Ray. I'm impressed. I really am.
I wonder if he's thinking the same thing about you.
I'm hoping. Because there's a lot of times when I do a horse for the first time,
mm-hmm.
they'll kind of give me a hard time, but I always figure that they're seeing what I know.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this is the clinch block, and this sets the nails.
Oh, I see. Okay, you drive that right into it. Okay.
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 It's on.
Terrific rein.
Now I finish it. I put it back on the hoof stand. I got a, this is a finishing rasp.
Mm-hmm.
Clinchers.
Mm-hmm.
And nail nippers.
This part was tricky.
Okay, big guy.
Nip those right off.
Right,
so
easy. And then you put a little, little groove underneath so it'll, it'll seat in there. And you take the clinchers. And then you take the rasp, and if there's any marks, you get off, shape the shoe a little bit.
You want that perfectly smooth, huh?
Yeah, I do. Well, Darla, we know he takes shoes, okay. He should never have any problems.
Rain may want to get used to those new shoes he's getting put on here because one of his first assignments is going to be to pull this old doctor's buggy from the 1880s that Darla wants to use for pleasure, maybe some parades in the future. With another Illinois story near Homer, I'm Mark McDonald. Thanks for watching.
Illinois Stories is brought to you by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by the support of viewers like you. Thank you. For a DVD copy of the program you've just seen, send 1995 to Network Knowledge, P.O. Box 6248, Springfield, Illinois 62708. Be sure to include the program name, subject, and when the program aired. You can also order with your credit card by calling 800-232-3605.